to say you gotta know somebody or know somebody to get somewhere these days. To say you know that's alright, yeah, that's alright.
So, like I was saying earlier, I mean, I love this business, I'm addicted to it, and my goal is to buy as much real estate as I can possibly buy right now, okay? Now, I've been doing this, pretty much that strategy, since around 2010 now. You know, I took a few years of slowing down during the years between 2005 and 2010 as the market was declining. I was actually selling some properties, doing some 1031s into some commercial pieces, and then I decided around 2010 it was time to start buying again. So Jeremy and I have been aggressively buying, and our goal is very, very simple. This is a part of our plan. I want to share it with you because I think this is a much, much better way of getting wealthy in this business. So we are out trying to acquire everything that we can, okay? And each deal we look at like it's a business to itself, almost as if I'm buying a business, okay? That particular piece of real estate must be able to sustain itself, by itself, okay? It must be able to do that. So it must be able to cash flow, and I know I can rent it, and it's not going to drain me for repairs. So it doesn't take a brain surgeon to figure this stuff out. You're in this business for a while, you'll figure it out. So that's kind of what we're doing. So we use, you know, these strategies that we're sharing with you tonight, just a little bit about what Jeremy was talking about. It's just touched on seller financing, for example. We use these strategies to allow us to buy as much as possible. One of the problems is if you want to go out and buy $5 million worth of real estate, and you've got some cash to put down, that's cool if you got some cash to put down. I've put down plenty of cash, all of my cash, all of my life on real estate. Every chance I got some money, it always went into real estate. And I've bought many a deals through conventional realtors like Herman and myself. I'm a licensed agent. We own the agency Addicted to Real Estate. I've done that many, many times and gotten mortgages from banks and hedge funds and wherever I could get the money. It didn't matter. But sooner or later, something happens with that plan. You run out of your cash, okay? You run out of your cash. If you have to put down 20% down or even 30% down when you're an investor, sooner or later that plan's gonna come to a screeching halt. So what the hell are you gonna do now? Well, you better have some other kind of way to buy houses. Well, that's where we're at, and that's where we've been for a very long time. Because, you know, I've got deals on the table all the time. I got $1 million deal on the table right now I'm trying to buy. If I hit the, right now at this moment, I don't have the cash available to buy it, but that's not stopping me. I'm gonna find it one way or another. But if a long lost aunt passed away and left me $250,000 tomorrow, I would just pick up the phone immediately, call the agent who has the listing on that deal, and buy it. So that money wouldn't be in my bank account very long. But the point is, unless you're a multimillionaire sitting on a pile of cash, you need to learn the strategies required to continue to buy. Where's all this going, okay? I've been doing this for 25 years. So what's cool about that for me, I started when I was 23 years old in 1989. And, you know, I'm 49 now. So what's cool about that is that I've kind of been there and done that all already. I've made tons of mistakes. I wrote all about my mistakes in my book. I'm not shy, I don't care. I'm proud of it, because everything bad that's ever happened to me in life only set my mind and opened the door for the next great thing to happen. I actually write about losing $25,000 in the stock market as one of the most positive things that ever happened to me in my book. Because it reminded me, what the hell am I doing in a stock market? I'm a real estate guy, I'm addicted to real estate, that's where I should be. Okay, so yeah, I'm not afraid to talk about my mistakes. But funny thing happens if you're in this business for a while. You learn that the easiest money you'll ever make in this business, and the real money you're going to make in this business, is from buying and holding real estate. Buying and holding it. Nothing else can compare to it. And in my career, the money I've made from buying and holding outweighs all of the flips and all of the wholesale deals and all of the other types of deals, you know, tenfold, easy, okay? And look at the year I started, if you pay attention to real estate cycles. In 1989, the market was sort of still at the top of the market, so I got in at a terrible time. And I was 23 years old and nothing was gonna stop me, I'm just gonna go out and buy, and I wasn't paying attention to cycles, and I bought some stuff at the top of the market. And then around 1991, things started to decline, and 91 to 95 were pretty tough years. And if you bought anything in 89, you probably lost 25-30% of the equity, okay? But then things started to come back slowly. Between 95 and the year, say, 2000, I was really starting to learn this business and starting to acquire a lot of real estate. And then between 2000 and 2005 was this is insanity, okay? Real estate prices were going up like crazy in this area. In Jersey, they were going up at 100% at the shore in maybe certain years.
So why do you think that happened? What caused the...
I think the stock market crash in summer of 2000 was the catalyst that made that happen.